Alright, today we're going to talk about some pork, yeah?
Yes, sir.
Alright, welcome back kepada episod terbaru, Shella. Ni Shella kan?
Shella, bro.
Aduh, pening saya lah. Banyak lah lah. Ada review lah, share lah, borak lah. Pening lah. Topik hari ni memang topik yang power gila je lah. Okay, kita akan bershare tentang topik babi.
Babi.
Babi. YouTube, jangan...
Jangan flag.
Sorry eh. Ini adalah... what do you call that? PSA. Public Service Announcement. Kau tahu kenapa kita nak buat video ni? Sebab aku punya IG, Sneakla punya IG, DM selalu kena. Bro, is this pig skin? Bro, ini PS ke tak? Eh, New Balance ni PS ke tak? Eh bro, ni PS ni. So, aku dah malas. So, kita buat video ni. Alright, so next time kau ada apa-apa nak tanya, kau refer video ni je. Alright. Okay, biasanya Victor atau Pablo akan buat video share lah. Tapi hari ni Pablo tak boleh buat lah sebab kita dealing dengan babi kan. So, Pablo better don't touch lah. Tak baik. Nanti kena samak lah banyak-banyak lah. Alright. So, that day, shout out to... What is that guy that goes around asking people to sambung ayat dalam Quran tu? Kawi lah. So, aku jumpa Kawi hari tu. So, aku tanya dia... is it okay for Muslim to pakai kasut babi, kulit babi? Walaupun dah mati, dah apa, dia straight up cakap tak boleh. Kalau dah terbeli pun tak boleh jual balik sebab you are encouraging the sale of something haram. Alright, so this is someone who dah belajar banyak-banyak tentang the Quran and what is inside the Quran. And this is what he told me. So, first off, I just want to get it clear. It's not good for Muslim to wear pig skin. That is your own apa tu lah. Kau nak pakai, aku tak judge. Okay, I'm just letting you know. No matter how you think, say it, memang tak boleh lah. Tapi at the end of the day, it's still your decision as an individual. Kau nak pakai ke tak nak pakai, I'm not here to judge you, okay? Alright, with that said, the first step, nak tahu kulit ni kulit babi ke kulit biasa, kau guna mata sendiri kau tengok. Itu number one lah. Okay, dia cakap biasanya ada 3 bintik. Okay, this is where the disclaimer comes in. Kalau kau selalu search kat Google ataupun mana-mana artikel, dia akan cakap 3 bintik. Tapi sebenarnya 3 bintik ni sebenarnya sangat susah nak tengok tau. So by the time you nak tengok close up, dah haram lah kau dah sentuh lah benda tu. Let's just get this out of the way, okay? There are few types of pig skin. One is usually kalau kasut Vans Vogue ada pig skin lining. So pig skin lining maknanya kat dalam sini. Ini lining, okay? Then there's pigskin suede. Pigskin suede ialah dua jenis. Hairy suede macam ni atau normal suede macam ni. And then there's normal leather, pigskin leather macam ini. Ini pigskin leather. And this is the Vans Vogue. You can see dalam sini pigskin lining. Sini pun ada pigskin. Alright? So, they are all actually sangat susah nak tengok 3 bintik ni. Tadi aku dah belik-belik nak tengok. There is this spot here whereby you can see like there's 3 dots. And they are very very hard to see. Dia susah gila nak tengok. Like for example kan, leather macam ni dia senang sikit. Kalau hairy suede mana kau nak tengok 3 bintik tu? Dia memang susah, okay? I'm not gonna lie, memang susah, okay? Suede ni senang sikit. You boleh tengok there are like dots here, okay? Tapi overall, rule number one, 3 bintik ni, I just want to tell you, sebenarnya dia almost a myth lah. Dia sebenarnya sangat susah nak tengok. Which is coming to the second step. Nowadays, whenever there's a shoe coming into Malaysia, diorang akan announce, especially sekarang New Balance tengah hype gila, dia akan announce benda ni made of pigskin. Dia ada buat dalam dia punya website punya post, dia ada letak pigskin material. That is one of the best way to know. Crossover punya kedai. Crossover is owned by a Muslim named Abang Jam, and they make it very 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 a lot of effort put into knowing whether material ni pigskin ke tak. So kalau diorang cakap benda tu tak pigskin, kalau diorang tak letak ada tak ada letak pigskin punya warning tu, maknanya kasut tu tak ada pigskin lah. So that is generally why if you are looking to buy New Balance, lebih baik kau beli daripada Malaysian punya store. For example, New Balance Malaysia punya store, dia akan letak piskin kat dalam kotak tu supaya orang Muslim yang kunjungi kedai New Balance, dia tak tersentuh kasut tu. Ada stores like Singapore, if you go to Thailand, Indonesia tak kan? Indonesia pun tak. Diorang tak berapa kisah pun. Only Malaysia yang akan, kedai-kedai Malaysia yang akan letak pigskin punya shoe kat dalam kotak-kotak supaya orang Muslim tak sentuh. Alright, that is the second one. Final one would be you need to do a lot of research before you buy it. Google sekarang senang gila kau nak research. You buka Google, you search, material list tu akan keluar dekat website-website and you can actually maybe hit up New Balance punya customer service, dia akan bagi tahu juga. Generally, as I know, brand yang produce pigskin kebanyakan is New Balance lah. And then the second in line is actually at one point Vans. Tapi Vans Vogue punya line dah stop dekat Malaysia, dia tak bawa masuk disebabkan oleh pigskin punya issue. Sometimes Adidas pun ada dia punya pigskin problem, but dia akan state clearly lah. Usually that will be for very very special edition like specials. So ada lagi banyak isu yang kalau tak silap New Balance kahat keluar hari tu. This issue memang besar gila sampai viral lah. Ada seseorang dia pergi tanya New Balance punya customer service, global punya customer service. Ni seorang budak lah, dia nak beli kasut ni. So dia tanya, dia screenshot punya receipt tu. Dia dah beli kasut tu sampai dengan receipt. Receipt tu ada tulis pigskin. Okay. Generally, kasut made in USA, New Balance, kebanyakan almost all lah is made out of pigskin. Tapi disebabkan this special release dengan New Balance kahat ni, dia bukan pigskin. So all the shop around the world assume yang kasut ni adalah pigskin. Dia banyak back and forth. And I have double confirm dengan the team dekat Kahat Malaysia, dan Kahat Malaysia dah confirm dengan New Balance Malaysia, and they are very very 100% certain. Diorang dah tanya dengan factory, benda kahat New Balance tu memang tak ada. Tapi this is the problem we always face in Malaysia. Kalau check on the website, global punya website, dia akan cakap ada pigskin. Tapi I would generally trust the shop and the Malaysian punya office untuk check bahawa kasut ni ada pigskin ke tak ada. Sebab benda isu ni memang sensitif kat Malaysia. So orang-orang Malaysia yang akan betul-betul check benda ni. So kalau the party from Malaysia cakap, for example I'm using Crossover or Kahat or even like New Balance Malaysia, kalau diorang cakap it is not pigskin, I would actually trust them over the website dekat overseas lah. Okay, so on this table I have a few examples of pigskin shoes and I few examples of non-pigskin shoes. Alright, you can see kalau suede, normal suede lah. Yang ni dia normal suede. This shoe is actually very very old, but it's normal suede. You can see there is a difference in terms of how the suede looks like. Yeah, to be honest, tiga bintik tu memang susah nak cari kalau you look here on this New Balance. Tapi walaupun tak ada this 3 bintik, kau just tengok dia punya suede punya details, you can actually tell. It takes a few years of experience in looking at a lot of pigskin shoes. Dulu kan, when first start out collecting kan, diorang selalu cakap, oh 3 bintik. Tapi selalu aku beli kasut babi ni kan, aku pergi cari, manalah bintik ni. Dia sebenarnya sangat susah nak tengok. What I'm trying to say is, suede dia memang akan nampak lain. Memang akan nampak lain. So you can see like this suede is actually very different from this. And you can see this is softer. This is a bit more cantik. That's why everyone likes New Balance. Tapi dia haram lah. For example this one, Harry suede dengan Harry suede lah. When it comes to Harry suede and Harry suede, there's really not much difference actually. Tiga bintik pun tak nampak. And Harry suede and Harry suede memang tak ada beza lah. So in this case, you just really have to trust New Balance punya announcement lah. Kalau memang ada babi, dia cakap ada babi lah. Kalau tak ada, then yeah. Okay, this one, let's talk about like normal suede. Like if you compare these two, I think the texture of both is also quite similar. I don't know how you can see it in the it's very hard lah actually. Dia memang susah gila lah nak tengok. Dia memang, I'm not gonna lie, dia memang sometimes for someone who never done your research, it will be quite hard. I will be very honest with you. Tapi you have to do a lot of research. You have to really read up on a lot of articles. There is a difference in the suede and after years and years of buying kasut babi dengan kasut non babi, kau akan tahu beza dia. Dia akan nampak lain. That's all I can say. But there are instances like this. FYI, this shoe is not kulit babi ya. Kalau kau tengok leather ni eh, dekat Sporty and Rich ni, dia memang soft gila, quality memang on point, cun gila kan. I know this pair pun banyak orang cakap is pigskin. It looks like pigskin but it's actually not. If you compare this dengan ni kan, quality dia hampir sama weh. So that's what I'm trying to say, like in this day and age, the leather punya quality pun dah cun. There's a reason why a lot of companies still like to use pigskin leather lah. Diorang suka guna disebabkan pigskin leather dia punya quality tu memang ada. Dia memang lembut and dia tahan lama. But there are cases yang macam ni, Sporty and Rich ni. Just so you know, FYI, kasut ni halal ya. And they are using calf leather. Tapi bila you combine, you just compare next to it, you boleh tengok kan, they look almost the same tau, leather dia. Dia punya quality memang nampak very very similar. So that's why a lot of people assume yang kasut ni bila time launch, yang ni kulit babi. But it's not. So you have to do your research. You have to really get a lot of experience in looking at, you know, tengok-tengok kasut yang ada kulit babi and tahulah perbezaan dia. And most importantly, always check with the retailer or the seller or the brand sebelum kau beli. That is the most important. As I said, I lebih trust retailer and brands yang dekat Malaysia, team diorang kat Malaysia, sebab benda ni sangat sensitif. Dia akan check dulu and buat announcement. Alright, with that said, I think we should go through like the majority of what are the brands yang usually sell pigskin. First thing first, New Balance. Majority of New Balance made in USA or made in UK punya kasut, dia ada pigskin. Second, Asics. Some of their gelite trees ada. Tapi jangan risau, KLCC dengan teh tarik is halal. We made sure that the suede yang material semua kita guna is halal. Kasut-kasut macam brand-brand macam Diadora, brand-brand macam Saucony, diorang pun guna pigskin selalunya. Saucony original selalunya guna pigskin. Another one yang sangat common ialah Vans Vogue. Vans Vogue, walaupun sini kain, dia punya lining kat dalam ni is pigskin. Ini sangat-sangat common, okay? Converse, majority of the time is halal disebabkan diorang, I mean Nike bought over them. So they are owned by Nike. So Nike almost never produces pigskin shoes. And also that's the same for Converse lah. Sangat-sangat jarang lah. So when special release keluar, if they are using pigskin, diorang akan buat announcement tu lah. Diorang cakap, oh this is pigskin. For Puma, ada juga release yang special-special release depending on the project. Tapi bukan yang ni lah, yang ni halal. There are some Pumas yang ada guna suede or material but very rarely. Adidas pun sama, aku rasa diorang pun dah slow down on the pigskin side. At one point, diorang pun ada keluar. Kebanyakan pigskin diorang ialah mostly collabs lah. Most of their GR stuff is usually halal, very similar to other brands. Selalunya diorang tak dapat achieve what the collaborator nak, dia akan use a special leather which is pigskin leather lah. Okay, I hope topik babi ni dapat menolong kamu. So kalau ada kawan-kawan yang diorang asyik tanya kau kan, diorang, eh bro ni babi tak? Babi, eh bro babi, babi, babi. Kau hantarlah video ni kat diorang. Jangan DM aku tanya ni babi ke tak. I'm just going to be very honest with you ah. I know this video dia, we never really go into detail of the leather sebab as I said many times, dia susah gila nak tengok sebenarnya. Alright, so just do your research, trust your retailers. And if you're in Malaysia, buy from Malaysia lah. Itu paling bagus lah, alright? So, sekian, terima kasih. Kalau ada soalan-soalan tentang babi-babi ni semua, kau tanya kat bawah, okay? With that said, tolong like, tolong subscribe. And see you in the next episode. Bye!